Many people can get confused with what post-traumatic stress and panic disorders are. They can get confused with it with football. For instance, in this situation, what happened was that Eli Manning had a 3rd-and-5 conversion to make because people must have been feeling very stressed about what would happen in the Super Bowl. Eli was going to get tackled, and then he came out, and he just slings it down the field to David Tyree. As you can see here, people must have been very stressed because it's the Super Bowl and they want their teams to win. Besides, this is considered Eli Manning's miracle because, as you can see, he caught it on his helmet and not on his chest. And no one knows how Eli Manning could have escaped pressure that easily. Another situation was this. The drive of the game for the Patriots and the Saints. Many people thought New England couldn't make it with 1:10 to go, especially with no timeouts, and they had needed a touchdown to win, but not a field goal. People didn't know if Tom Brady could do it. With 43 seconds left in the game, Belichick, Brady, Colley, Edelman, all of them must have been feeling very stressed, and even the fans. And here, with 10 seconds left in the game, Brady throws it to the end zone for Kenbrell Tompkins to win the ball game. We can get stressed this way sometimes, but this is not a disorder. One more example could be in Super Bowl 46, a rematch of Eli Manning's miracle throw to Tyree. Here, Brady had only 5 seconds left in the ball game. Patriot fans must have been feeling very stressed. Could Brady make it to the end zone? Could he do it? He throws it to the end zone. Everyone was stressed, but he missed it. It's all Gronkowski. He dropped the football. That's what many people think. They can get confused with football. But this is not a disorder.
Stormtrooper! Rebels, take him out! We need to take out the officer! We need to take out the turret!
Get the hunt off! Knock them off! Target the turret!
Lock that turret!
Okay, now you're just playing spook.
Listen to me!
die entry 459. Our soldiers on the planet Kamino are Sith Empire of soldiers. Have been suffering from post-traumatic stress. This is due to their bombings of the enemy, the Jedi, in fact. They've seen their families dying from them. They're traumatized by these moments. But war keeps going. Terrorist attacks from these off-worlders have seriously given them nightmares. We have tried helping them with medication and therapy. Hopefully, this will bring us back into the war. Seems that the therapy and medication work. We have driven the enemy back to their forces. Well, looks like we're back into the war. Hopefully, we can win this war soon. I'm getting tired of searching for the Starforge. But if all else fails, Starforge may be the only thing that's good for us.
Trooper!
It seems that the therapy and medication didn't work after all. Our men are now suffering from both post-traumatic stress and a panic disorder. They keep feeling chest pains in their chest, and they keep thinking they have a heart attack. In my opinion, they're just feeling blaster bolt head right there, making them die. This is never going to work.
Full of it on the job.
Hurry, take out that turret! Cover off!
Watch those blasters!
Watch your mind.
Is that all you've got?
Are you blind?
Seems that the disorders have been gone for a moment, letting the soldiers to pull back the enemy. Now, our medics have suggested, once again, therapy and medication help but not have this happen. This never worked the first time. I seriously doubt this will work the second time. Dead. But even then, there's our only hope.
We captured a command post. They're losing reinforcements. We captured a command post. Enemy reinforcements are declining.
Four. 463. Well, once again, it didn't work. In fact, we have lost the battle. We've lost the planet. This war is never going to end. But soon, the Star Forge will be found. And also soon, my apprentice will be strong enough. Together, we will destroy my master. And I will be the master. That is the way of the Sith. There can only be two. Greetings, Health Class. I am Darth Revan. Now, I am red something you all. 1 million credits. So that you will not be sick next time.
1 moment, Lord Revan. This is my apprentice, Darth Revan. He may have been telling you, you must comply with our demands. You must do this at the stroke of midnight. You must give us 1 million credits, or else we know where you all live, and we will put gas, poisonous gas, into your bedrooms at night, unless you comply with our demands.
No, the gas isn't poisonous. It will simply make you ill for the next 3 months. If you want to get this antidote, you must pay us 1 million credits. If you don't, we'll send you a shipment of this sort of remedy so that you would not die within the 3 months. This gas will not kill you. It will make you sick.